I just hope it all goes well. Thanks everyone for supporting as well, really appreciate it.
The road is long, with a many a winding tongue.
So, currently just over the 5 mile mark. Completed the 5 mile of death. So I'm not really too sure what happens after this, because obviously I've never been past this point, but you know, welcome to the unknown. So yeah, going strong at the moment, slightly under time, not too much where I'm burning too much energy, but yeah, feel good, feel fresh. It's raining, so it's helping me keep cool, but at the same time a little bit hard on the foot when it gets to the sort of muddier areas, but we're making good time. So I apologise that people are going to have to see my honking grid a few times every couple of hours, but hey ho, alright, it's for a good cause. If anyone wants to donate, please go over to my page. Obviously I've shared the link numerous times, so just go on there if you want to get a bit of an understanding as to the reasons why I'm doing it. Again, please click the link and it'll give you a little bit more information there. Literally just coming up to the 9 kilometre mark, so making good time. Anyway, have a good one, enjoy your weekend. Cheers. Right, so just coming up to just past the 13 mile point. Obviously just over half marathon completed. Two full marathons to go, but we're getting there. So the terrain has been pretty difficult. There's been some patches where it's just been almost impossible on the foot to go any sort of quicker than sort of 20 minutes a mile, 25 minutes a mile. Just the rain making everything really boggy. But we seem to be out of it now. I've sort of hit, turn the camera around, sort of hit a bit of a easier stretch now on the footpath. Some nice scenery. So yeah, getting it done. All the other participants and that seem spot on, so I was having a bit of a chat with a few of them. But yeah, we're getting there now, so I'm thinking I'm probably going to hit the quarter mark. I'd like to think in the next probably hour and a half, so I'll have hit the quarter way. So yeah, anyway, enjoy. Like I say, if anyone wants to donate, please go over to my page. Obviously I've shared it numerous times, just click on the link, you're able to donate there or share it. Obviously spread awareness about mental health, the reason why I'm doing this. All right, so have a good one, enjoy your weekend, cheers.
He ain't heavy, he's my brother.
Cheers for supporting. Next quarter off we go.
Right, I've got to go.
How's it going?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Feeling it.
And now thanks again everyone for supporting. Literally on the way now, just about to leave the third stop, and then make the way to the halfway point. So no, feeling good. I had a little bit of a wobble, probably about an hour or so into that last leg, which is why I was a little bit quiet on social media and that. I just wanted to get my head back in the game. But yeah, I had a stop now, patched my feet up, sorted out my hot spots, hydrated, food on board. Let's get it done. Nice one, thank you.
See you later.
Nice one, see you in a bit, Chris.
Yeah, see you in a bit.
So, just tipped over the 34 kilometre mark, just left the first sort of major rest stop. Terrain has been hard, been some big hills, sort of slowed things down quite a bit, so I was making good time. Probably had about, I don't know, maybe half an hour or so in the bank, sort of heading to that slightly. No big deal. Getting on alright now. Energy levels feel good. Things got my Facebook page. Obviously there's numerous posts on there for myself about why I'm doing it, why I'm raising money for Mental Health Research UK. So I can say pop over and have a look at that. Flip the camera around, some good views, some lovely views at the moment. See over to the right hand side. Nice bit of wind to keep it cool things down a little bit. But yeah, I'll check back in later. Cheers. Calves and that, and my hamstrings are just really tight. So I'm looking forward to getting to that rest stop and just stretching up. So, apologies for the slow update. I've been had a bit of a moment, probably about an hour or so, maybe 45 minutes ago. A little bit of a wobble. I didn't feel too good, but got through it. So I've just gone past the third rest stop, and on my way to the halfway point now. So this is the shortest leg that I'll be doing. I think it's about 9 kilometers or so. So apologies for staying off social media. Like I say, I just wasn't feeling too great. Nothing too bad. I just had a bit of a few stomach cramps and that I had to deal with. So we're getting there. Looking forward to hitting that halfway mark, so I can take a good sort of 40 minutes, 45 minutes or so, square my life away a little bit. I think the one thing that I didn't really anticipate that maybe is taking a little bit longer than what I thought is when you actually get to the rest stops, you know, getting your hot spots and your blisters and that patched up, you know, you obviously have to go into a queue. So that was about 15 minutes out to wait before I even got seen to, which obviously is time onto the total at the end. So yeah, I think if I was ever to do it again, that's probably one thing I would factor in a little bit more, just those times to take at the aid stations. But such is life, we're getting on with it. You're right, Lee, just seeing that you've popped up there, mate. Top man. But yeah, getting there, scenery's good. So again, just on the coast. Let's see a bit of where we're heading. And yeah, making it happen. Like I say, jump over onto my page if you want to have a little bit more understanding as to why I'm doing this. If you want to donate, obviously my Just Giving page and that is also on there. As you can see, the sun's come out, which again has made it slightly more challenging, just because it is pretty warm. There's a nice breeze, but it is, you know, it's a good 18, 19 degrees at the moment. But yeah, we're getting there. All right, cheers, Lee. Cheers for that, bud. But yeah, I'll update you shortly. Probably when I get to the halfway point, I'll put a picture on or something. So yeah, stay tuned. All right, cheers for everything. Thank you. You're doing good.
Getting it done. Just gonna pop in and get some bits sorted, and then I'll be back out.
Okay.
I'll come and see you.
Brilliant.
Oh, yeah. Not bad, just going to sort my feet out a little bit.
Ooh.
Get some compede on there.
Yeah.
Yeah, now it's going all right, and then I'm going to go in there.
Brilliant.
Get sorted out.
Lovely.
Other than that, now it's going all right.
Good.
Over halfway.
Brilliant.
One thing. Hello.
Hello.
No way. Be careful of my stuff, mate. Oh.
Hello. I don't think you're going to be out here.
I do, mate. I stink. No way! That's class! Oh, right.
Hey,
bit of morale, that is.
So look, someone's got your poster.
I was thinking, like, that's a bit random, like, why is he filming me again?
To be fair, I have filmed you a lot.
here, it's under the archway you go.
We'll see Daddy
in a unless you're really going for the loo, then go there first.
Cheers, mate.
See you later. Awesome. Yeah.
Thanks very much. I need to go.
Cheers. Good luck. See you later.
I can't believe these guys have walked all that way and have got lost.
Let me see your sign.
Let's see the sign.
Hello. So, just leaving the halfway point. One of the major sort of rest stops. So I stopped there, managed to get my fresh set of boots, fresh socks, take my feet up. Obviously, hot spots and blisters starting to form at the moment. Managed to get some food on board as well, which is good. And then the shock of my life, my wife Katie and Reese turned up, which I wasn't expecting to see because I thought she had plans today. So that was a really, really nice surprise. Nice little morale booster moving forward. So I've got a 10-kilometer leg now to the next rest stop, where I'll probably look to stop and just stretch off, change my socks again, admin myself a little bit. But yeah, we're getting there. My spirit's still good, still feel fine. Legs are obviously quite tired, but I was expecting that. But yeah, I think I've got a few big climbs to come now. So I'll say bye. Cheers for watching. I'll speak to you soon. Cheers. Cheers, matey. Thank you.
How you doing?
Yeah, not bad.
Yeah?
Getting there. Yeah, just gonna sort myself out for 10, yeah, 10, 15 minutes or so.
At least it's calmed down cracking. A bit.
I need to get off my feet. Oh. Yeah.
I said I need some towels. You went to one on top as well.
Love you, mate. Sleep well, yeah? Make sure you have a good sleep. Love you, bud.
He will.
See you later, Chris.
See you later, Phil.
Top man.
Yeah, off you go again.
Yeah,
yeah,
and next time I see you, it'll be at the.
Yeah, see you. Bye.
Love you,
bye. Love
you, bye. Love you all.
Cheers, Phil.
Love you all. Cheers, Chris. Thanks very much.
See you
again,
later,
mate. Top man. Cheers for putting me up.
It's all right, it's a pleasure.
The lodger.
Well, I have seen you a lot, actually, but.
See you later. Love you, mate. Top man. Right, sleep well.
See ya.
Mind the bears.
Morning. So, I know I've been a little bit slow on the updates. Obviously, didn't want to be putting anything on through the night because I know most people would have been asleep anyway and probably not too asked about what I was saying at that time in the morning. So, yeah, just a quick update on the progress of how we're getting on. So, I'm probably about 4 kilometres away from the final checkpoint before the last stretch. Currently sitting at just coming up to 56 miles. So I've got about another 10 miles or so to push before the end. It's been hard. So obviously through the night, but been all made easier. I've partnered up with a bloke over here, Craig. All right, he's helped me through. Helped me through a few of the dark moments in the evening. So yeah, massive thanks to him. But yeah, we're getting there. Looking at probably finishing around probably about 0930, 1000, that sort of ballpark area. So still on track for me, obviously moving for under 24 hours. So like I say, if you want to understand any more reasons why I'm sort of doing this, please go over to my Facebook page. Obviously have a look at the Just Giving link. And there'll be a bit more reasoning on there as to why I'm doing this. Obviously raising awareness for mental health, and obviously raising funds for Mental Health Research UK. So yeah, nice bit of scenery to come. Probably a nice few hills as well, but such is life. Spirits are good. If I'm honest, I've actually felt quite good throughout the whole process. There's not been any points where I've had any sort of major issues or sort of contemplated quitting the event. spoke to someone earlier. I think there's been quite a lot of dropouts this year, by all accounts, especially of those that are doing the full 106 kilometres continuously. So yeah, just looking forward to getting it done. Looking forward to getting to that finish line now. So yeah, thanks everyone for watching anyway, and hope to catch up with you soon. I'll keep you updated when hopefully I'm closing in on the finish line. All right, cheers. Thank you. Have a good day.
The road is long.
So this is a couple of miles making way around here. We've got Craig at the front. £40 in the bag behind him. Peter's seeing everything in there. Well, welcome, Craig. Special person to give you a medal, alright? You win a child, there you go. Thousands of them, you win a medal and a child. Congratulations, guys, keep going, almost there, I promise you. This is it, the end of the challenge. Mental Health Research UK. And time for a medal. Congratulations.
How are you feeling?
Sore. My feet. I've never been in so much turmoil in my entire life. But no, I feel good. I feel good to have it done. I feel like a lot of pressure. I think that's the thing at the moment. A lot of pressure's been lifted off me. Just with, like, obviously everyone supporting and that. Yeah, it's just... Yeah, just flabbergasted.
Well done.
So finally got it done. 106 or 107 kilometers this year. Apparently it was 107, so they blagged us a little bit. My GPS clocked me at 69.2 miles, so about 3.2 miles longer than what I initially thought it was going to be. But yeah, far and out hardest thing I've ever done in my entire life. Yeah, some challenging moments there, but you know, made all the better by obviously my wife being here, my uncle-in-law, and
hello,
this little one here. But yeah, what I'd like to just say, so obviously this is going to be the last one of these that I do. You know, if you want to go out and do something, just go and do it. You know, the proof's sort of in the pudding. I mean, I was unable to train for a lot for this event, so I've kind of gone into it a little bit cold. But again, you know, it's amazing what the body can achieve, you know, if you put your mind to it. So yeah, again, don't listen to anyone as well that can't tell you can't do something. You know, 106 kilometers is no mean feat, you know, in, I think it was about 27 hours or so that I ended up doing it in the end, with the inclusive of all the rest stops and the aid. But yeah, no, thanks everyone for watching. Thanks everyone who's donated and shared the page. It genuinely means a lot. And obviously I'm glad I could do something, obviously, in you know, in memory of Steve. Like I say, if you want to know any more about the reasons as to why I've sort of done this event, and chose the Isle of Wight in particular, just go over to my Facebook page. Obviously I've posted it numerous times on there. And obviously just click the Just Giving link and you can get some more information there, and obviously donate if you still haven't and you wish to. But yeah, thanks everyone for the support throughout. You know, it hasn't gone unnoticed. I know I was a little bit quiet in the sort of darker hours because, you know, I was having a few dark moments myself at times. But yeah, no, thanks everyone for supporting, and look after yourself. All right, cheers, take care.
You know, if you want to go out and do something, just go and do it. You know, the proof's sort of in the pudding. I mean, I was unable to train for a lot for this event, so I've kind of gone into it a little bit cold. But again, you know, it's amazing what the body can achieve, you know, if you put your mind to it. He's my